Hello students, today in this video we are going to discuss some questions from the chapter we had discussed earlier. Why do we fall ill of class 9th biology? So here are some multiple choice questions we will discuss about that. So the first question is, which one of the following is not a viral disease? So you have to choose a disease which is not caused by a virus. So from the options, dengue, AIDS, typhoid and influenza, your answer is typhoid, because this dengue is caused by virus, AIDS are also caused by virus, influenza is also a viral disease, but this typhoid is caused by the bacteria Salmonella typhi. So your right answer is typhoid. Second question is, which one of the following is not a bacterial disease? So you have to choose a disease which is not caused by bacteria. So as you know, this cholera, tuberculosis, anthrax, these all diseases are caused by the bacteria, and you have to choose the disease which is not caused by bacteria. So the answer is influenza, because it is a viral disease. Next question is, which one of the following diseases is not transmitted by mosquito? So as you know, brain fever, malaria and dengue, these diseases are transmitted by the mosquito. And this typhoid disease, this is a disease caused by bacteria and transmitted by the house flies and contaminated water and food material. So your right answer is typhoid. Now come to the next question, that is, which one of the following diseases caused by bacteria? So here there is some one correction in this question, that is, which one of the following disease is not caused by. You have to find out the disease which is not caused by bacteria from this question, because this typhoid, anthrax, tuberculosis, these are diseases are caused by bacteria. This malaria is caused by the protozoa. So the right answer is malaria. Next question is, which one of the following disease is caused by protozoan? So the options are malaria, influenza, AIDS and cholera. So as you know, the malaria is a protozoan disease caused by the protozoa known as Plasmodium. So your right answer is malaria. Next question is, which of the following can make you ill if you come in contact with an infected person? So high blood pressure, genetic abnormalities, sneezing, blood cancer. So very easy, sneezing can infect a person. So your right answer is sneezing. Next is, AIDS cannot be transmitted by. Options are sexual contact, hugs, breastfeeding, blood transfusion. So the right answer is hugs. Okay, AIDS can be transferred by sexual contact. Breastfeeding also transfer the virus from mother to the child, and blood transfusion is also responsible to transfer the virus from infected person to the healthy person. But this hugs is, it cannot transfer the virus of AIDS from unhealthy person to healthy person. So the right answer is hugs. Next question is, making antiviral drugs is more difficult than making antibacterial medicines because viruses have very few biochemical mechanism of their own. That's why. So your right answer is 8C. As you know, the viruses are not a true cell, that's why they have very few biochemical mechanism, and for making the drugs we use biochemical mechanism to cure any disease. So that's why, because viruses have very few biochemical mechanism, so that's why it is very tough to make antiviral diseases. And as you know, the bacteria is a true cell, so these are having so many biochemical mechanisms, and we can interfere any one of them and can easily eradicate from the body. So the next question is, which one of the following causes Kala Azar? Okay, Kala Azar is a protozoal disease and caused by Leishmania. So the right answer is Leishmania. If you live in an overcrowded and poorly ventilated house, which of the following diseases is possible that you may suffer from? Okay, the question is saying that if you are present in overcrowded and poorly ventilated house, so which disease can occur very easily? Which disease can occur, can having more chance to infect you? So airborne diseases, because if you will live in overcrowded and poorly ventilated areas, so the air will be infected. The air will have more and more number of germs, and via air you can get infected. Next question is, which one of the following is not important for individual health? Living in clean space, good economic condition, social equality and harmony, living in a large and well furnished house. So for being healthy, it is very necessary to have a clean space. Social equality and harmony is also very necessary for mental peace. Good economic condition is also very necessary for having proper balanced diet. So it is not necessary to have a very large and well furnished house. So your right answer is the D option. Choose the wrong statement. High blood pressure is caused by excessive weight and lack of exercise. Yes, this is right. Cancers can be caused by genetic abnormality. Yes, it is also true. Peptic ulcers are caused by eating acidic food. This is not true. Okay, acne is not caused by staphylococci. This is true. So your right answer is option C. Now the next question is, why should not allow mosquito to breed in our surrounding? Because why do we not let the mosquitoes breed in our surrounding? So the options are multiply very fast and cause pollution, bite and cause skin diseases, are vectors for many diseases, are not important insects. Very easy, as you know, the mosquitoes are responsible to carry the pathogens of various kind of diseases like dengue, malaria, chikungunya, encephalitis, etc. So the right answer is mosquitoes are vectors for many diseases, so we should not let them breed in our surrounding so that they will not be able to spread the disease. Next question is, you are aware of polio eradication program in your city. Children are vaccinated because why do we vaccinate children in polio eradication program? Because vaccination kills the polio causing microorganism, prevents the entry of polio causing organism, it creates immunity in the body, all the above. So on the right answer of question number 14 is, it creates immunity in the body. We vaccinate the children to immunize their body, to make their immunity strong for protection against any kind of infection. Now the next question is, viruses which cause hepatitis are transmitted through. Hepatitis causing viruses are transmitted by. The options are air, food, water, personal contact. So the right option is water. Okay. Contaminated water causes the hepatitis. The viruses of hepatitis, they live in water, and if the water is contaminated with the hepatitis water, so that it can infect anybody. Now the next question is, vectors can be defined as. The options are, animals carry the infecting agents from sick person to another healthy person, microorganism which cause many diseases, infected person, diseased plants. So the vectors are the animals that carry the infecting agents from sick person to another healthy person. So the answer A is the correct. Which one of the following has a long term effect on the health of any individual? So the options are common cold, chicken pox, chewing tobacco and stress. So you have to choose which one of the following will cause a long term effect on the health of an individual. So common cold is a very acute disease. It can be finished off very easily. Chicken pox also an acute disease. Chewing tobacco. Chewing tobacco will cause long-term effect, because as you know, the tobacco causes cancer. Okay, so that's why this is the right answer. Next is, which disease is not transmitted by mosquitoes? So dengue, malaria, brain fever or encephalitis, pneumonia. So the disease dengue, malaria and brain fever, these are diseases which are transmitted by the mosquitoes. Okay, so your right answer is pneumonia, because this is the disease which is not transmitted by the mosquito. So the right answer is option D. Next question is, agent of a disease are. So it is asking that which one of the following organism is agent of a disease. So as you know, the viruses are responsible for causing the disease. Fungus are also responsible for causing a disease. Bacteria, they also cause disease. So the right answer is all of these. Okay, these all agents can cause the diseases. Now the next question is, jaundice is a disease of kidney, liver, pancreas and duodenum. So jaundice affect our liver. So the right option is liver, option B. Now the next question is, which of the following can make you ill if you come in contact with an infected person? So this we had discussed earlier also. So sneezing is the right answer. Sneezing, while sneezing, lots of germs come out from the mouth and spread into the air, and when any other person inhale that infected air, this cause the infection. So this is all. Thank you.